Hi, I'm Jim Covington. Today is February 14th, 2013, and I'd like to welcome you to this week's issue of ISBA Statehouse Review. I have four bills that were introduced yesterday that I went through this morning very quickly that I'd like to talk to you about. A fifth bill, it may be voted on today, and that is the marriage equality, the same-sex marriage bill that may be voted on in the Senate today. If it's passed out of the Senate, it will not be voted on in the House today because the House is not in session this week. The four bills I'd like to talk to you about is the first one is Senate Bill 1636, which amends the uninsured motorist provisions of the Illinois Insurance Code, and it makes arbitration binding in UM cases, uninsured motorists, regardless of the amount that the three arbitrators would award. Under current law, it is not binding if the award is more than $50,000 for one person or $100,000 for two or more persons. This just simply repeals that cap so that all awards are binding in arbitration, and that was just introduced. The second bill is Senate Bill 1565, introduced by Senator Delgado of Chicago for amending the short-term guardian statute, and it terminates the appointment of a short-term guardian if a temporary custodian for the minor is appointed under certain provisions of the Juvenile Court Act, and that was just introduced. The third bill I'd like to talk to you about was also introduced by Senator Delgado yesterday, and it amends the Illinois Wage Payment and Collection Act. Under current law, the Department of Labor may administratively have procedures to adjudicate claims for $3,000 or less under the Act. This simply removes that $3,000 cap so that the department may adjudicate claims regardless of the amount under that Act. That was just introduced. The fourth and final bill I'd like to talk to you about this morning amends the mortgage foreclosure article of the Code of Civil Procedure. And I may stumble a little bit here because there's a lot in this bill. I didn't have a chance to really digest it as well as I should have. And it's Senate Bill 1602, introduced by Senator Collins of Chicago, and essentially does four things in the mortgage foreclosure article. The first thing it does is it allows the landlord to terminate a tenancy established before the confirmation of sale only at the end of the term of the lease agreement by written notice issued not earlier than 90 days before the end of the term of the lease, or in the case of a month-to-month or week-to-week tenancy, by 90 days written notice. The second thing it does, the entry of judgment of foreclosure does not terminate or otherwise affect the rights of or interest of any occupant of a dwelling unit who has a lease or tenancy resulting from an arm's length transaction and who is not the mortgagor, whether or not the occupant has been made a party in the foreclosure. I apologize for kind of reading this. We're all aware of our oral advocacy courses in law school where only a vegetable reads his or her brief, but I just didn't have time to digest this, and I did summarize this in writing a little more cleanly on the screen for you. The third thing it does is the holder of the certificate of sale, the holder of the deed issued under the certificate, or if no certificate or deed was issued, the purchaser at the sale shall assume the lease or tenancy of the mortgage real estate resulting from an arm's length transaction entered into before the confirmation of sale, assume any federal, state, or local housing subsidy contract for the dwelling unit for the duration of the contract, or assume lease, whichever is shorter, assume his or her interest in the mortgage real estate subject to the rights of any occupant, and finally, not terminate the occupancy or any occupant's tenancy except as otherwise provided in the code. The final thing it does, it requires the purchaser who offers money or some other valuable incentive to an occupant of a dwelling unit as an incentive to vacate the premises to tender that offer in accordance with specified procedures. That was just introduced and will be heard in a couple weeks in committee. Thank you for tuning in, and we will see you next week.